Hello, everyone. So we are here today with Mr. Kennedy, and we're at the Peachtree Village International Film Festival. And I'm so excited to be here with you today. Like, I have so many questions for you, so hopefully we don't go over the time. So how are you feeling today?
I am feeling good. I'm excited about being here. Flew all the way in from Los Angeles, California. And I am just enjoying all this great creative energy.
I can only imagine. So I know that I've read up on your history. At night, you did nightclubs and even talk show, radio hosting, all that good stuff. Then to go from that to writing and filming in your own movie, that must take a lot of perseverance. So just give me a little background on how that all happened.
You know, people used to say, oh, Leon, you're so talented. You write, you produce, you direct, you star. And it really had nothing to do with talent. It had to do with lack of opportunity. And here's what I mean by that. When I started off, there was a real scarcity of opportunity for people of color. So I knew that I was going to have to come in the back door. So the back door was, when I was 15 years old, I had a plan. And the plan was, okay, I'll be a disc jockey. I'll be a big on-the-air personality. From there, I'll get my own TV show. And from there, I'll do movies. So I started following that plan when I was 15. So by the time I was 16, I became one of the youngest disc jockeys in the history of Cleveland, Ohio. By the time I was 18, I did have my own TV show. By the time I was 26, I was doing major motion pictures. So when Penitentiary came out, it was the number one independent film of the year, which is a big deal anytime, but especially back then, and especially for a so-called black film. So you think, okay, number one film in the country, rave reviews, this is John Travolta, Saturday Night Fever time. In other words, your phone should be ringing off the hook. And the reason I said Saturday Night Fever is because that was a big hit, you know, back then. And yet my phone didn't ring at all. So I had an agent, and I said, I don't understand this. I've got the number one film, and yet there's no film offers coming in. He said, Leon, they don't know what to do with you. You are a black leading man, and there are no parts for black leading men. He said, you're not even a comedian. There are no parts for you. So I had to learn several things. One is write my own. Then after writing it, raise money and go out and sell it. Raise money and go out and make a deal. So that's how I learned to write. That's how I learned how to produce. And that's how I continued to be an entrepreneur.
That is amazing. So I'm sure that you have pretty much opened the door and paved the way for so many of us. What made you want to be a part of the Peachtree Village International Film Festival?
Well, that one's easy. First of all, Lynn Gibson is a phenomenal human being. He's a great person, has a great heart. He wants to help people. And Lynn and I have been friends for probably 10 years now. We talk all the time. And we started trying to help filmmakers to find distribution, because a lot of people now are making movies, but you make a movie, then what? You know, I tell people all the time, you can make gold in your room, but if you can't get the gold to the marketplace, it has no value. So if you have a film, you've got to get it out there. You've got to build an audience. And then even if you have a film that's a good film and a hit film, you got to get paid. You should get paid fairly instead of robbed and raped. And too many times that's what happens to independent filmmakers. They're robbed and they're raped. So Lynn and I have been trying to help filmmakers get the proper distribution for their labor.
That is amazing. I know we definitely need that, because it's an industry where you can lose a lot that you've created. With that being said, what do you look forward to seeing here in Atlanta? It's a big market right now for movies. Is there anyone in particular that you've taken under your wing? Or is there someone in particular that you would like to see move for a little forward? I want to know.
Well, instead of talking about specific people, I'll talk about this generation. This generation has a lot of opportunities, certainly a lot more than the generation that I worked with in. And so what I want to see them do is the sky is the limit. In other words, and it's not just minorities, it's women too. The door is wide open for women now as producers, as directors. whatever they want to do. And so we need to take advantage. This can be another golden, well, not another, but this can be a new golden era for us. I would also like to see us collectively start putting our money together so that we don't have to go hat in hand for permission to a major studio to get a film done. I think that we should be able to do our own. I think that we should be able to own, control, distribute, market. The whole thing we should be able to do ourselves. We should be able to green light ourselves.
Love it. Is there any advice that you can give to me and to the rest of, you know, people that are trying to be in the movie film industry?
Sure. First of all, don't let anybody put out the flame of your dream. Keep your dream going. How do you do that? I believe in prayer. I believe in God. I believe that we pray and that we get divine ideas. From those divine ideas, we pray and we get divine favor. The spirit of favor will go out and open up doors.